We acknowledge that we're meeting on Dja Dja Wurrung country, of which the Jara people have been custodians of for millennia and have performed age-old ceremonies of celebrations of initiation and renewal. We acknowledge their living culture and their unique role in the life of this region. We express our gratitude in the sharing of this land and our sorrow for the personal, spiritual and cultural cost of that sharing, and our hope that we may walk forward together in harmony and in spirit of healing.
Thank you. Good evening to our Chair, Mr. David Jemmett, members of the board, special guests, staff, students, parents, and all Girtonians. It is important that we come together tonight in celebration, albeit virtually, to acknowledge the effort and achievements of our students in another extraordinary year. Likewise, it's valuable to take this time to reflect and consider the resilience of our students, of our staff, and of our entire school community. Because when we reflect, we grow. We take the time to embed in our minds all that has been good about the past school year. Students and staff who were at the school last year will understand from the Girton Gratitude Project the importance of an attitude of gratitude, the power of being thankful, and the power of expressing appreciation. We know that focusing on the positive is crucial, and that reflecting and sharing can help us learn from the hardships that we have all faced. And that is exactly what we will do tonight. You will recall that the start of the year began with our senior school and junior school house swimming carnivals. These events represent so much at Girton, but above all, they are an explicit tribute to the community, connection, and to fun. Despite the announcement at the senior carnival of a 5-day snap lockdown commencing that evening, spirits could not be dampened. Those precious memories and the positive perspective helped see students through their first period of isolation for the school year. Well, if we had been told at that time there would be 5 more lockdowns yet to come in regional Victoria, some of substantial length, I'm not sure we would have believed it, having all carried into 2021 a sense that this year would be better than the last. The personal toll of the coronavirus pandemic has been profound, and everyone's struggle has been unique to their own particular set of circumstances. Yet, somehow, even through the shadows of 2021, many, many students have shone. At the start of the year, based on outstanding VCE results, 4 students were selected to perform in the prestigious VCAA Season of Excellence in Top Class Music, Top Class Sound, and Top Talks. 1 student went on to win a VCE Premier's Award. Junior school students who braved the shave for the Leukemia Foundation raised an incredible $20,000. Around 250 students door-knocked for the annual Red Shield Appeal in Bendigo after being recognised at the regional event launch as one of the single biggest contributors to this charity across Victoria. An astoundingly good senior school production was staged to a small COVID-safe audience with performances utterly contradicting the disrupted rehearsal schedule. If there could be more, a junior school Tournament of Minds team won the international final of this wonderful annual competition. A Year 11 student won the annual Victorian Parliament Prize. 2 Girton students achieved first and second place in the state final of the 2021 Plan Your Own Enterprise competition. And there was certainly plenty of sporting success when students were able to compete, with many students qualifying for the state cross-country finals and wins and places in the Loddonmalley and Sandhurst regional finals of football, soccer, and table tennis. And in 2021, in defiance of the odds, there were plenty more student achievements besides. Well, just as students are recognised at this 2021 speech night, we understand that everyone deserves acknowledgement. Acknowledgement for persisting through 2 challenging school years. Our school community is made up of many medical professionals, professionals who have helped keep us safe, of small business owners who have struggled to go on, of salaried employees who have never ever worked so hard, and of parents who have supported children through home learning while taking care of their own elderly parents. Our own teachers continuously reinvented the craft of teaching so that our students continued to receive the education we expect at Girton Grammar School. Well, none of it has been easy, and whatever amount of resilience that you have mustered to make it to this point, we deeply and sincerely thank you. The school recognises that we are all the sum of our experiences at school, at home, and elsewhere. And while individual students will be recognised this evening, I would like to formally acknowledge the collective effort of our entire school community. And thank you. Thank you for supporting our students and simply getting through the year. Our focus with our students, as we learn together what living with COVID actually means, is to foster a deep sense of respect. This is how we will get to what is behind the numbers. What lies behind the daily counts of COVID cases, exposure sites, hospitalisations, and deaths? Well, that's the very human and the very personal cost of the pandemic to each individual. As the government works on a macro level, as a school, we are working on the human level and developing strong relationships within the school community is going to continue to be essential to enduring through the ongoing effects of a worldwide pandemic. This is one of the most powerful ways in which we nurture a respect for the intrinsic value of every person. Please enjoy the opportunity this evening to reflect on the positive aspects of 2021, to acknowledge whatever role you have played in supporting our students this year, and to accept that every single student's success is the shared success of our entire community. Thank you.
Good evening to our head, Dr. Clayton Massey, Deputy Head, Dr. Emma O'Reilly, Head of Junior School, Mr. Don Thompson, Deputy Head of Junior School, Mrs. Viv Barth, fellow members of the board, life members, special guests, staff, students, parents, and old Girtonians. On behalf of the board, I congratulate all the students who will be formally recognised during this evening's Speech Night presentation. To strive for excellence during challenging times takes commitment and motivation of the highest order. As Dr. Massey has suggested, I encourage every member of our school community to take pride in the success of each student tonight, because perhaps more than ever, each individual success that is acknowledged represents in part the success of our entire Girton community. As the school continues to navigate our daily operations during the coronavirus pandemic, remaining focused on keeping staff and students safe and delivering the quality of education expected by our community, we have all had to accept that this year, like last, has been different. We've had to adapt our expectations of exactly what is possible during a global pandemic, while ensuring that standards are maintained and our values upheld. I believe that Girton has done this well, and the board will continue to support the school in maintaining best practice in the provision of quality education in a safe environment. I would like to take this opportunity to thank every staff member at Girton for another incredible year of work for our students. That some of the student achievements that Dr. Massey highlighted have even been possible is a tribute to the hard work of many of Girton's teaching and non-teaching staff members. On behalf of the board, I wish to acknowledge the extraordinary lives that all parents and carers have been living since the beginning of last year. Board members all have children at the school, and we understand and appreciate the sacrifices that many families make to send their children to Girton, and that those sacrifices have come into sharp focus during the pandemic. We will continue to work hard to dampen the impact of the pandemic on the school as much as possible. It is a time of great uncertainty for many families, and the effects of the pandemic, social, emotional, and financial, will likely linger. What we do know is that in uncertain times, strong leadership and clear direction is essential. The board will continue to support Dr. Massey, Dr. O'Reilly, Mr. Thompson, and Mrs. Barth in doing what Girton does best, and that is to let our values of respect, empathy, confidence, and excellence to continue to guide us. The board's work on the school strategic plan and direction for the school continues with an eye to an unpredictable future, however, striving to provide our students with the teaching resources, facilities, and opportunities to allow them to put their best foot forward, regardless of the situation around them. I would like to thank my fellow board members for their time and efforts over the past year. Your wise counsel, sage advice, and countless voluntary hours are certainly noticed and appreciated. Per aspera ad astra. Our school motto seems particularly apt this year. And so, in closing, on behalf of the board, I commend our staff, students, parents, carers, and entire school community on seeing through a difficult year. And we strive ahead with confidence that Girton's foundational document, its mission and values, which has served us so well over the past 28 years, will continue to do so well into the future. Congratulations again to the students who are about to be formally recognised. Thank you and have an enjoyable evening.
It is now my pleasure to announce the 2021 Junior School Speech Night Awards. The Warhurst Family Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Prep D, Hugo Mule. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Prep M, Ashley Guao. The Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence, Prep, Napoleon Gua. The Strathdale and Malden Pharmacy Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies at Year 1D shared equally, Houston Dennis. The Bryan Family Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies at Year 1D shared equally, and the Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence Year 1, Rosie Cool. The Strathdale and Malden Pharmacy Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies Year 1M, Maddie Kenobi. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies Year 2M, Catherine Morsillo. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies Year 2V, Keisha V. Grover. The Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence Year 2, Grace Beattie. Miss Batterham's Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies Year 3D, Nina Shannon. Miss Batterham's Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 3M, Audrey Sheng. The Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence, Year 3, Stella McIntosh. The Bishop Matt and Mrs. Rachel Brain Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 4M, Lauren Lung. The Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence Year 4, Archie Yuen. The Sanderland Family Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies Year 5D, Shun O'Malley. The Sanderland Family Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies Year 5V and the Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence Year 5, Sophie Marnie. the Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 6D, Maggie Barber. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 6V, the Central Victorian Orthodontics Prize for Effort, Dedication and Achievement in the Performing Arts, Year 5 or 6, shared equally, Nikki Chima. The Warhurst Family Prize for Endeavour in Junior School Inclusive Education, Upper Junior, Ethan Hendricks. The Bryan Family Prize for Endeavour in Junior School Inclusive Education, Lower Junior, Hazel Anderson. The Sandland Family Prize for Achievement in Sport, Grace Doby. The Han Taekwondo Martial Arts Training Award for Effort and Dedication in Sport, Thomas Seapolt. The Olive Gordon Memorial Prize for Effort, Dedication and Achievement in the Visual Arts, Macy Fisher. The Cooney Family Prize for Effort, Dedication and Achievement in the Performing Arts, Years 3 or 4, Maya Dhanapala. The Strathdale and Malden Pharmacy Prize for Dedication, Effort and Achievement in Music, Years 4 to 6, Isabel Wibgen. The Bryan Family Prize for Effort and Dedication to Instrumental Ensembles in Year 6, Zara Chamundra. The Beaver Family Prize for Excellence in Music Performance, Nicholas Chong. The Fisher Family Prize for a student leaving Year 6 who is a good all-rounder, shared equally, Stephanie Carlson. And the Bryan Family Prize for a student leaving Year 6 who is a good all-rounder, shared equally, Farley Bobart. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 2D, and Miss Batterham's Prize for Citizenship, Lower Junior, Shifra O'Malley. The Bryan Family Prize for Citizenship, Middle Junior, Bella Kenobi. The Dr. Tyler Moe Prize for Excellence in Science, Thomas Brain. The Old Girtonians Association Prize for Ducks in Year 3, Gracie Seapolt. The Old Girtonians Association Prize for Ducks in Year 4, shared equally, Michael Huangfu. The Bishop Matt and Mrs. Rachel Brain Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 4D, and the Old Girtonians Association Prize for Ducks in Year 4, shared equally, Rashiv Sasalu. The Central Victorian Orthodontics Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 5M, and the Old Girtonians Association Prize for Ducks in Year 5, Charlotte Thompson. The Strathdale and Malden Pharmacy Prize for Citizenship, Upper Junior. The Sanderland Family Prize for Leadership, School Captain, shared equally, Hamish Worm. The Sanderland Family Prize for Leadership, School Captain, shared equally, Ruby Flanagan. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 6M. The Dr. Tyler Moe Prize for Effort and Dedication and Achievement in Sciences, Years 5 or 6. The School Prize for Second in Year 6, shared equally, Kira Collins. The Global Chiropractic Prize for Effort and Dedication in Studies, Year 6H. The Central Victorian Orthodontics Prize for Effort and Dedication and Achievement in the Performing Arts, Years 5 or 6, shared equally. The Bryan Family Prize for Excellence in Foreign Languages. The Ruler Prize for Excellence in Social and Emotional Intelligence, Year 6. And the School Prize for Second in Year 6, shared equally. Shanley Wickramasinghe. The Aidan Burton Prize for Excellence in English. The Cooney Family Prize for Excellence in Humanities, the Pickering Family Prize for Excellence in Mathematics, the Old Girtonians Association Prize for Ducks in Year 6, Harshal Balraj. Well done to all of this year's recipients. Good evening, students, ladies and gentlemen, to our second virtual junior school speech night. This time last year, we were hopeful that 2020 was an anomaly, a one-in-a-kind year that would not be repeated. And here we are, having worked through what I think is fair to say is another very challenging year. Before I reflect on 2021, I would like to take the time to thank our chair, Mr. Dave Gemmett, and the Girton Grammar Board for their efforts and contributions to our school in 2021. Last year, they steered us through the challenges of very tight fiscal constraints and worked very hard in the background to assist those families that were hardest hit financially by the COVID pandemic. Their trust in us to provide excellent service as we face the challenge of more lockdowns and forced remote learning has been unwavering. Their support has allowed us to continue to extend ourselves to provide our students and families with the best education, even under the restrictions we faced. I would also like to thank Dr. Massey for his leadership in his first full year at Girton. Dr. Massey has not yet experienced a normal Girton year. His experience has been marked by starts and stops, restarts, and more lockdowns. Even so, he has embraced the technology that we have been using and has ensured he has a weekly presence in the junior school, even when we could not be there in person. Our students will not soon forget his appearance as a roving reporter during a Zoomed assembly in one of the rare weeks mid-year when we were on campus. Of course, I must acknowledge our junior school team for the work that they have put into ensuring our students and families are cared for. This time last year, we all breathed a collective sigh of relief. Thank goodness that year was over and we could look forward to a year free of lockdowns. Well, that wasn't to be. Once again this year, our staff took on the challenge as they came. When lockdowns were announced, they turned up the next day to teach online or supervise on site without missing a beat. Those who have never had the opportunity to coach, teach, or guide a group of young people may not be able to imagine how different that prospect is when they are not there in front of you. They will never know how much work needs to go into changing the format so the lessons can be presented online and be as effective and relevant as when they are presented face to face. Many of our staff were also juggling the needs of their own families. They were managing the anxieties of their students, sometimes the anxiety of their own children, and often the concerns of the parents in their classes. Reflecting on how quickly we needed to adapt and change our routines to ensure our children were not only educated, but also cared for emotionally, it was evident to me that this could not have happened with just our teachers attending to the students. All of our staff have stepped up and stepped in. Our admin staff, our teacher assistants, our inclusive education aides, everyone took on a role either at school or remotely. As was the case for the teachers, our support staff were challenged to take on roles that they were not necessarily trained for. And once again, they rose to the challenge. Everyone supporting our students, from our deputy head to our junior aides, did so with a calm and reassuring approach. The thing that I admired the most amongst all of our staff was the way that they put the needs of their students above their own needs and concerns. For this, I'll be forever grateful and thank each and every one of them with my utmost sincerity. While 2021 has not been the year that we had hoped for when we finished 2020, it has not stopped our students from achieving. Facing and overcoming challenges helps children develop resilience, particularly when supported by adults who provide positive modelling and show that a problem is just a challenge to be overcome. Our children have been fortunate that they are surrounded by this modelling at home and at school. On the way to visit our Year 3, 4 and 5 students on camp early this term, I had the opportunity to reflect on how the lockdowns have impacted our students. I love visiting camp because I get to see our students outdoors, engaging in activities and challenges they wouldn't get a chance to do at school. I also love the drive and the opportunity to listen to some podcasts and to reflect and honestly be with my own thoughts. This year, I was fortunate to stumble across a podcast involving Jason Semple. Jason's a retired New South Wales and Federal Police officer and an author. Jason was only 2 weeks into his career as a young constable when he was faced with a tragic event that caused him a great personal toll and cost a colleague his life. For many people in this situation, returning to work would have been impossible. Jason not only returned to work, but forged an incredible career that took him all over the world. When asked what drove him to not only continue in his career, but to go on to such success, his answer was simple. There is no growth without adversity. Facing and overcoming adversity allows us to grow. Without struggle, there is no growth. Clinical psychologist Dr. Judith Locke, who we've been working with this year, talks about children having to live in the struggle if they are to develop resilience and learn how to overcome challenges. Well, this has certainly been another year of challenges, but our students have been well supported to work through the struggles and to grow through the adversity. They have come out at the end of the year as stronger, more confident learners. Once again this year, our students, under the creative guidance of our teachers, have managed to overcome the challenges to produce some excellent work. Even while faced with the interruptions of crying younger siblings, overly affectionate cats who insist on hogging the screen time, or puppies who disrupt a whole class by vomiting mid-math lesson, our children have powered on. This year saw our first online Girton's Got Talent, where students performed everything from singing, dancing, and acrobatics to magic tricks, all without being able to see their audience. The creativity on display in the different year levels was inspiring. So much so, it inspired our teachers to respond with their own version of I'll Be There For You, a creative and well-meaning video that I'm sure left Mrs. D rocking in the corner for days and validated all of our careers well away from a microphone. Our Tournament of Minds teams prepared hard all year and just when they were ready to present in person, had to pivot at the last minute and produce a video for the judges. One of our teams won, and then went on to represent Victoria, where they won the national title, all through Zoom. The combination of coordination and cooperation that had to happen to take out a national title when they weren't even in the same room together is outstanding. Our drama staff supported our Year 2, 4 and 6 students to perform in a junior school production, regardless of the lockdowns. Many rehearsed online in drama classes or in extra Zoom lessons and worked frantically while we were at school to produce an excellent version of Madagascar. While we couldn't have our usual art show, our students still worked hard to get their work completed, and Mrs. James created a street show for our parents to enjoy. Each new challenge was met with creativity and perseverance to ensure that the challenge was overcome. While we do not want to repeat this experience next year, one thing we have learned is that our children have developed resilience. They have learned to push on regardless of the learning challenges, and they have adapted and grown. The difference in the way our children have approached the lockdowns this year compared to last year is quite remarkable. We know that it's not ideal, but if we have to, we know that we can take on the challenge and come out stronger at the end. Challenges are not new to our school. Last year I spoke of the challenges faced by Mrs. Ahern and Mrs. Millwood when they started Girton and had to overcome the challenges of not having a permanent site for their school. Well, 100 years ago, the school was also faced with challenges. In 1921, the school was facing teacher shortages, they were under scrutiny from the school registration board, they were struggling under financial pressure, had two of their managing committee and a headmistress resign, and were closed by the Board of Health for a month because of an outbreak of diphtheria in Bendigo. They didn't give up. Thanks to the generosity of their patroness, Mrs. Charlotte Frew, they were given some financial help. Mrs. Frew signed a loan the school had with her. She signed it back to the school for free and convinced the other creditors to do the same, wiping the debt. They managed to get an excellent head in Miss Brownlee, who raised the standards and attracted some excellent teachers, and the school went on to thrive. They faced the adversity, they overcame it, and they grew. I'm proud to be part of this history and that tradition. This year, as it did in 1884, in 1921, and in every year since, our school has remained true to its motto, Per Aspera ad Astra, through hardship to the stars. My sincerest thanks go to every member of our junior school community for supporting us and our students to strive through their years from hardship to reach our stars. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to the Junior School Speech Night 2021.
We would like to acknowledge the head of Girton Grammar School, Dr. Massey, Deputy Head Dr. O'Reilly, Head of Junior School, Mr. Thompson, and Deputy Head of Junior School, Mrs. Buff, members of the board, staff, parents, and students. This year has been one of adaptation, a year of changing to suit every possible circumstance.
We have become adept at changing direction, changing expectations, and changing the way we work and play.
The evolution of us humans, known as Homo sapiens, has taken millions of years. We have gone from being basic mammals with no spoken language, hunting and packs, to modern humans who travel space and worship social media.
Speaking of millions of years, the last two have felt pretty long.
They have felt long, Ruby, but getting back to evolution, I think Darwin had it right when he concluded basically, those who adapt the best survive, and at this school, we're survivors. Through a global pandemic, we have continued to learn, we have stayed strong, and we have still celebrated school milestones, sometimes from home.
Darwin, so warm, so tropical, so many crocodiles.
Not that Darwin, Ruby.
Oh, right, I knew that, I'm listening. Evolution, you bet, we've done well.
A really good example of adaptation at its best at Girton this year was the whole school Zoom Olympics. Inspired by the real thing in Tokyo, we took to the virtual field by competing in classroom groups in games of charades, a treasure hunt around our homes, a group crossword, categories, and a quiz letter. I'm proud to say that in the junior school, my class came out as winners and we enjoyed a prize canteen lunch together.
Continuing the evolution theme, we did manage some real-life events this year too. The swimming, athletics, and cross-country carnivals all ran with the help of the senior school students. It was evolution before our eyes, with the strongest, fittest, and fastest winning. Congratulations to Jenkin for winning the swimming, Riley for winning the athletics, and Jenkin for winning the cross-country. The Spirit Cup this year went to Riley House at the swimming, and Riley House again at the athletics.
The Tournament of Minds competition was adapted to be held online, and our team of Year 4, 5 and 6 students did Girton proud by winning the international final in the STEM category.
Year 6 students tried to beat the evolutionary process by fleeing to COVID-free Canberra, with the virus nipping out of Victorian heels. In fact, all camps in the junior school have been completed this year, thanks to the tenacity of our wonderful staff who refused to give up on booking, then rebooking, then booking again every camp for every year level.
The junior school production has evolved from being a traditional stage play at the Capitol Theatre to a radio play last year and a live stream production this year. The production of Madagascar has been so enjoyable and it has given many students informal leadership opportunities.
The evolution of the school's history continued this year at our annual Foundation Day church service, where Dr. Massey was formally inducted as the head of school, and we continued the junior school tradition of reciting the prayer for the children.
Pray for the children, by the children. Hang on, is that insulting to us?
No, Hamish, you might be as tall as a 15-year-old, but you're still technically a child. How else did we evolve this year,
Well,
Hamish?
There's the Girton's Got Talent show, which went digital this year. Auditions were still held in each class, and winners were awarded in each year level and then overall. This year, two sisters won their respective year level competition and then teamed up to win the overall award. So, overall, 2021 has been quite a challenge because we've continued to what we normally would, but in different ways we have evolved.
If all evolution has been going on, Hamish, why is it that hummingbirds, who have been around for thousands of years, still don't know the words?
I don't think you quite have the hang of this evolution thing yet, Ruby, but it doesn't matter because you're fit and you're a survivor. That will stand you in good stead as we head to the senior school next year.
We would like to conclude by making some special thanks. There are too many people to mention who have supported us through our Girton Junior School journey, but I would like to thank Mr. D for being a part of my lasting memory of the junior school teachers. What a note to finish on. Thank you, Mrs. Barth and Mr. Thompson, who have steered the ship and made the junior school the wonderful place it is.
And I would like to thank Mrs. Barth and Mrs. Milner for a memorable Year 6 full of fun and learning. Thank you to Mr. Flanagan for being my first Girton teacher in Year 4, and to Mrs. Levitt for being an excellent viola teacher this year. And finally to Mr. Turner for his warped sense of humour in Year 5. He and Mr. Thompson are very good at dad jokes.
And finally, Hamish, I would like to thank you for your friendship and hard work as a fellow junior school captain, and the best wishes to the new junior school captains for 2022.
Thank you, Ruby. Even if you didn't always get my jokes, I've loved working with you. Congratulations also to the captains next year.
Thank you and good night.
It's
It's now my pleasure to introduce and induct the junior school captains of Girton Grammar School for 2022. The first is Sophie Marnie from Frew. Congratulations, Sophie. Sophie, I receive and commission you as junior school captain of this school for 2022. May God guide and bless you in the work of this office. I counsel you to act with firmness, lead by example, to seek humility, and above all, to serve your fellow students and your school in every way you can. Receive this badge as a token of this office to which you are called. Please join me in congratulating Sophie on her achievement. The second captain of the junior school for 2022 is Oscar Worm from Ahern. Congratulations, Oscar. Oscar, I receive and commission you as junior school captain of this school in 2022. May God guide and bless you in the work of this office. I counsel you to act with firmness, lead by example, to seek humility, and above all, to serve your fellow students and your school in every way you can. Receive this badge as a token of this office to which you are called. Congratulations, Oscar. I congratulate both Sophie and Oscar and look forward to their leadership of Girton Grammar School in the junior school in 2022. And so we move to the senior leadership positions of the senior school of Girton Grammar in 2022. And I welcome 2022 Vice Captain Astrid Johnston Millwood. And Isaac Willits, Jones House. Congratulations, well done. Astrid and Isaac, I receive and commission you as Vice Captain of this school in 2022. May God guide and bless you in the work of this office. I counsel you to act with firmness, lead by example, to seek humility, and above all, to serve your fellow students and your school in every way you can. Please join with me in congratulating the Vice Captains of Girton Grammar School for 2022. It is now my distinct pleasure to welcome and induct the School Captains of Girton Grammar School for 2022. Congratulations and welcome, Renna Nicol, Ahern. Congratulations, Renna. And William Hamilton, Jenkin. Congratulations, Will. Renna and Will, I receive and commission you as school captains of this school, Girton Grammar School, in 2022. May God guide you and bless you in the work of this office. I counsel you to act with firmness, to lead by example, to seek humility, and above all, to serve your fellow students and your school in every way you can. Congratulations, Renna and William. Congratulations to our Vice Captain and Captains of the School for 2022, and I look forward to your influence and leadership in the coming school year. Well done.
What a wonderful night celebrating the hard work and the great achievements of our students. It's worth celebrating always, but all the more given the difficult year that we've all had. My congratulations to all of you. No, despite a challenging year, we have much to thank God for. The growth and learning of all our students, the hard work and service of many in our school community to keep it all going, and the resilience and strength God has given us all to get us through a roller coaster year, just to name a few of them. And so, as we've reflected on the year, as we give thanks and as we look forward to a time of rest, let me pray a blessing over you all. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious towards you. May you know his rest and his peace until we meet again. Amen.
As we draw the 2021 Speech Night presentations to a close, may I again congratulate students who have been recognised formally this evening. This recognition is essential. It brings with it a sense of fulfilment for individuals, and it engenders a sense of pride within our school community. When I inducted the 2022 prefects, I asked them to seek humility, which entails an ability to genuinely celebrate and share the success of others. I know that every student who has received acknowledgement this evening will carry with them an appropriate sense of pride in their achievements, that they will share with their family and friends. As the saying goes, a rising boat lifts all tides, and this is the essence and intent of our annual Speech Night event, which we dearly hope to host in person next year, so that we may all experience the rising Girton tide together. I will close by offering my deepest thanks to the board, our dedicated teachers, our reliable administrative staff, our supportive and loyal families, and most of all, our vibrant, resilient, intelligent, funny and kind students for an extraordinary year of work. Thank you and good night. Thank you.